Okay, what is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Eternal Oblivion, aka Black Salamander, the Older Worker, and Speaker What's Good. Now, before you get on me, I know I am 1 week late for showing and doing a reaction on this goddamn trailer of Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle. I heard all the news about what's going down, and I'm just like, yo, I'm pretty much shook. We're going to talk about that, but first, I got to see this Blake gameplay, because I only saw a picture of Blake. I didn't really see, like, the whole gameplay trailer of her, so with all that being said, man, plus our system dropped this during the Fighters beta, you know your boy was like, Fighters! So, let's get down with this reaction. Alright, let's get down with this. And big shout out to Seth for tuning me out the trailer. I ain't know Koei had it, so I'm tripping. Alright. So this is pretty much, like, every beginning. What we got? All right, we got Ragna. Hide. Oh, snap, a new map? Hey! Okay, this is a new map, too. Jin and Yu. Yeah, that's a new map. But is that for Under Night? Or I low-key thought that was Persona 5. I don't know why. All right, that's Under Night. Okay. Hey, my meat lover and my squirrel waifu. Yes. Team grab bat. All right. Okay, that has to be a Ruby stage. This has to be a Ruby stage. Ruby and New 13. Weiss and S. I'm still shocked that S is in this game. I'm still shocked about it. Hey, they got the classic school gate. Okay. Alright, so pretty much this is all the characters. Is it over 20? Yeah, I think it is. Yeah, I think it is. Alright, Blade Blue Cross Tag Battle. Now show me the waifu. Oh snap, it's coming out May 31st. So from my knowledge, I think it was on June 5th that we're getting it. Hey! Oh snap! Hey! Okay, look at Blake! Let's go! Yo, she looks clean as hell! Alright! Okay, from Shadows. Blake, oh snap! Oh, shit. Damn, okay. Alright, so pretty much that's everybody. Damn. Okay, the silhouettes are not gonna help because they're new models. The silhouettes are not for the help because all these are new silhouettes and new characters. Like, old characters with new silhouettes. So it's like, you don't know who could be who. I remember seeing a freaking Hakumen one. That shit was pretty funny. Alright, now let me check out Blake. I want to go check out Blake. Oh, girl, look at her. Look at me with the eyes. Oh, yes, baby. Yes. Yes, dude. Oh, my God. Alright, so pretty much I haven't even seen Blake use her gun. Nah, show you some guns. I feel like they're gonna do another stream and they're gonna show off new and improved gameplay with Blake. But other than that, yo, she looks pretty dope. Damn, I really love how she looks. But y'all already know what's hurting us. This is really what's hurting us. Will be available on DLC. I know everybody and their mothers are like losing their mind to the fact. Now, I can't really say as much right now because I want to talk more about Blake because she looks so good, but the fact that she's DLC is really hurting me. Like, honestly, another reason why I really did not want to do this reaction because when I heard to the fact that Blake was going to be DLC, I said, fuck everything. Like, I still want to support Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle, but to the fact that Blake is going to be DLC, that's crazy. That's even telling us that Yang is going to be DLC. That really hurts me. I don't know how to feel. On some real stuff, it really hurts me to the fact that our system works is doing the whole DLC with the remaining group of Team Ruby, Blake, and Yang. It's crazy because you would have thought that Ruby, Weiss, Blake, and Yang would automatically be in the base roster, but now it's like Blake and Yang are freaking DLC. And like, for real, I did not want to do this video. I'm gonna be honest with y'all, 100%. I don't want to do a fake reaction. Like, I'm gonna be dead ass. I haven't seen it, so I definitely didn't want to, like, you know, come through here with a fake reaction. I absolutely feel hurt. Like, Blake gameplay looks fucking amazing, but to the fact that our system works when I have a DLC, and apparently this is something for practice, and y'all already know how our system works, how DLC characters like $7.99, so basically $8. So I think somebody came up to the root of how many characters is it going to be. 21 characters being DLC, so that's probably going to be like 100 or something. But that's, it hurts me to the fact that Blake has to be DLC. because it's like, yo, the main cast of Ruby should already be in the base game. I would expect like T. Juniper, Crow, maybe Cinder and them would have been like DLC. Okay, but the main team, half of the team, two is in the base game and two is in the freaking DLC. Like, what the fuck? I'm not understanding that. Like, yeah, I understand y'all want to do some practice, but it's really, like, to me, it's really hurting me because, honestly, I want to see a Ruby game come out after the success of Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle. But seeing that Arceus and Works is doing something like this is really hurting me. I'm not mad at them, but it's the fact that it's a terrible-ass idea. Like, this is really driving everybody down. Again, I did not want to do this because, fuck, dude. Because when I heard about it, I was pissed. But I didn't want to show it, and I honestly don't want to show it in this video, but it's like, fuck, why? Like, if it wasn't for the announcement of Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle, I honestly would never gave Ruby a chance. I never shitted on Ruby, but it's like, yo, I never really looked at it. I didn't know how lit it would be. I didn't know how good, like, the fights will be, the plot of the story. Like, if it wasn't for Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle, I honestly wouldn't gave Ruby a chance. And it's like, yo, I saw Ruby. I'm caught up with Ruby. I love Ruby. Dude, I have so many fucking Ruby shirts and all, bro. Like, yo, I really love the series. I'm mad that I slept on it, and it's like, Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle introduced that Ruby characters was coming in. I'm just like, yo, that's awesome. Let me go check out the show. I've grown to love the show. I love the characters. I love the plot. Man, I lost my girl, Pyrrha. I'm not trying to, like, be the center of attention, but it's like, it's hurting people, and it's also hurting the potential of Ruby getting a game, because I, in my heart, I was thinking, damn, if Cross Tag Battle do successful, like, the future Cross Tag Battle, if it be successful, maybe Ruby would get its own game. Like, that's honestly what I thought. It wouldn't be like another Art System Works, it'll be something else, you know, showcasing what happened between Volume 1 up to 3, or maybe the 4, you know, etc. I was thinking that Ruby would get his own game, but seeing that Art System Works is doing this for some type of DLC practice is kind of stupid, to the fact that, damn, you are hurting the future of a good ass game. You got Dragon Ball FighterZ out, and then Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle came through at the announcement of EVO last year, and now y'all doing this. Fuck, dude, I'm hurt. I'm absolutely hurt. That's all I wanted. I wanted this game to fucking succeed. Like, we don't know now. I don't even know now. It could still succeed, but it's like, I saw so many people on Twitter talking about they're not really supporting it as much as they are now. I'm still going to support Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle. Don't get me wrong. I'm still going to support it. People may call me a sellout for it, but I'm still going to fucking support it. Why? For Ruby. That's it. Because I honestly want Ruby to get its own little game as well. It's like, if Cross Tag Battle gets successful. But seeing this, it's like, damn. Man, like I said, I did not want to do this video because I knew I was going to be on a huge rant because Avatar and them told me about it. I see freaking Koei doing it. It hurts. It really hurts. Oh, dude. And it's crazy because these two are the main fucking favorites. Yang and fucking Blake are most of the main favorites of Team Ruby. And it's like, they're DLC. That's fucked up. That's absolutely fucked up. Y'all know how much people love Blake and Yang? That's fucked up. Y'all want them as DLC? Oh, they gonna buy them. That's fucked up. Don't even get me wrong. Sprites. I understand that. It takes time. But, bro, why you couldn't just have the main four be in the base game and everybody else from Ruby could have been DLC? Hell, they even got characters from Blaze Blue, freaking Unyel, and also Persona that's going to be DLC as well. So why not put the main four in the base game? Like, I'm not disrespecting y'all to the fact that, you know, sprites is a lot. Yeah, I don't know how to do sprites. And I know that shit takes a lot of time. But it's like, this idea of having Blake and Yang as DLC, that's crazy. Like, I hope this gets situated. I hope it do. And apparently the main game supposed to be like, what, $52? Like, still close to $60. And what, we don't even know what the season pass is going to look like. And apparently there's a limited edition where you get the game along with the season pass. Man. I still want to support it. Like, I still want to support it. But, man. I don't know, man. I'm just gonna end it off right here. I hope you guys have a blessed day. I'm still gonna support Cross Tag Battle regardless. I want Ruby to succeed, bro. I want our sister Worst to succeed too. So I'm still gonna support Cross Tag Battle. Like everybody else, literally their hype is down. And I can agree. My hype is like kinda down. It's in the middle. It's like 50%. So everything right now with our sister Worst dealing with Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle is 50% with me now. So I'm gonna end the video right here. I can't do it no more. I can't do it. Push me to the back to the